No tasting, Tanara McClain. Ixnay on the tasting, because we do things responsibly here at Breakfast Television.
There are rules we must
there
follow.
There are rules in place, courtesy of the good folks at the CRTC, who tell us that we cannot taste this temptation, no matter how alluring it might be. We can, yeah, absolutely. We can stare at it, we can look at it, we can appreciate the bottles.
Chocolate peanut butter banana.
There you go. Now, the reason we bring these bottles up here today, of course, a big event happening in our city, as it does every year, it is the Edmonton International Beer Fest hitting the Shaw Conference Center. These are just some of the beers that might be available. 200 different tasting options there, and we just wanted to present this to you to bring you, as you said earlier, just a bouquet of options on the flavor front. Now, we are not going to drink these.
Okay,
let's be
promise.
Very clear about
yep.
that. We are going to touch them.
This is nice and cold.
Sniff them.
Yes, okay.
It's cold. It is
yeah.
a cold beer. Perfect.
Yeah, this one is small.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Well,
thanks for coming in, by the way. I like how she rushed over here as soon as she heard
magic.
We were talking about beer. Tanara McClain makes her way to this studio. All right, now, Michelle McDougall, which one are you going to talk about?
I am holding the Hog's Back Porkalypse Now. It's an oatmeal bacon stout. And thanks to the fine folks who brewed this in Ontario. They don't usually bottle it, but look, it's got the stubby bottle. So I think I might have left my yogurt in the fridge, so I'm just going to have a look here. There must be something in the fridge.
And that's very interesting, because you do see these flavorful beers coming forward now. We've got this one right here, which is actually with donut. How to make a beer less healthy for you, right?
Yeah,
how to like completely eliminate any virtues for
and
it.
You know,
oh, hi, Michelle.
If I would have taken a sip, I probably would have picked up the light caramel taste and the fine, even bacon aroma, too.
That's, bacon.
That would have been a lovely beer if somebody would have been able to try it.
There you go. And of course, Carla, you have a specific beer that actually almost seems brewed for you, tailored for you.
Yes, gluten-free beer. So they're hard to find, and they often don't taste amazing. So, but oh, this other one has a cork. So,
okay, well, she's going to take care of this.
Yeah,
she's going to make sure that, yeah.
Yes, this one here has a cork.
Oh, so, good. If I had tasted that one, I would say it was bitter and that there was kind of a citrus aftertaste to this one. I don't typically like beer. It tastes just like beer.
There you go. Yeah,
very
for those of you that need
but
to have the gluten-free beer. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Now, of course, you've had to go on the fly here because you were not anticipating being part of this segment. Do you have a beer that you're looking to try?
I like that Going Dutch. I like the name of it, Going Dutch. It's actually a local one here made in Sherbrooke. It's the 10th anniversary beer. Looking quite nice. And the packaging is... if I can get that right. The packaging is actually quite beautiful looking at it. It's a very nice classic looking. And
it is a very large beer, by the way.
I spilled some down here.
Oh, darn it. That's too bad.
Just gonna step away.
Yeah. Beer Fest, of course, kicks off today, which is perfect timing for
absolutely.
There's like 200 different types of beer, so a lot more than what we're seeing here. This is just a
this is only a drop in the bucket, isn't it?
Now, the one that I'm interested in, just real quickly, because I know we're running out of time, it's the Texas Ranger from Michler. It's what I like about this actually is it says that it has a chipotle flavor to it, something with a little bit of spice. I'm a big fan of, let's see, we get over there, go. I'm a big fan of things with, oh shoot, hold on, sorry. I am getting a call from an unknown number. I will be right back.
Okay,
and you know
good.
What, while he's taking that call, this bottle of beer right here actually costs over $100.
Oh,
can you believe that?
So we probably won't be drinking it. We'll
no.
be saving it. Yeah.
This is what
forever.
You probably want to save forever, definitely.
Good news, I want a cruise.
Oh,
so.
Excellent.
I want a few of those.
Expense paid, but all the beer you can drink.
Just, obviously because we can't sip this on air, I'm just going to rub this on my fingers.
Oh, it's
oh,
so
look
dark.
At how dark
there
that
you
is.
Go. Look at that. That is awesome, right?
Isn't that
and best as I can tell
like
from the
sauce.
Touch and the feel of it,
uh-huh.
it has a, it's not overly spicy, but it does have a nice stout, fudgy flavor to it. So there's kind of a tinge of chocolate in there. Definitely one that I would recommend, and I can't lick my hands no matter how enticing this might be at this point.
Yeah.
So
we're all very good around here somewhere.
This seemed like a good idea at the time.
Is it okay? We're not allowed to drink. Is it okay if we give each other
we can
cheers?
Absolutely do
yes.
an honorary cheers, of course.
Oh,
this is
exciting.
In anticipation of this weekend's Edmonton International Beer Fest coming to you at the Shaw Conference Center. There you see there running the next couple of days. Today starting at 4 o'clock, tomorrow at 3 p.m. All the information you need is at breakfasttelevision.ca. And we'll have more Breakfast Television coming back at you here. We'll have the entire news, weather, traffic team rolling out as we continue on this Friday morning.